y'all. So, hold on, sorry. All right, so still going strong with the curly girl method. Sorry for the bags on my eyes. No, I'm not sorry. That's just how I look. Shit. Anyway, so look. What I did this time was I did the co-wash with the Suave Naturals. This time I did not put in my Burt Bees. Instead, I used the Uncle Funky's Daughter Curly Magic, which is a curly pudding type of deal. Kind of has the consistency of a Kinky Curly and a lot of other those curling jelly type deals. But I do like this product. It is organic. It is Curly Girl approved, blah, blah, blah. If you hadn't heard of Uncle Funky's Daughter, I actually like a lot of their products. Well, okay, let me not say that. I've tried the Curly Magic. I like it. I've tried the Super Butter and the Extra Butter, and I love both of those. I really like the Super Butter. But I've had this for a while. I have so many products that I need to just go ahead on and use. So, yeah. All right. I'm going to be roller setting my hair, but not the same kind of roller set. This is going to be like a twist spiral rod set, I guess. We're going to see. Anyway, this would be my wash and go, minus the when it gets dry and shrunken and it shrinks up right here. And it's not even have a problem with shrinkage. I have a problem with the shape. So at some point, I'm going to get my hair shaped. So what I did was, after I rinsed out my conditioner, I finger detangled with my co-wash conditioner. And then I put in the Funky's Daughter. And coated every strand. I'm going to be using the big humongous jerry curl rods or perm rods and my end wraps to achieve this deal. Got me a little top part here, a little more funky. All right, so I got this idea, not that I hadn't seen it 100 times before, but I was just kind of reminded of it from Simply Unique. Simply, you know how to spell simply. And then her unique is Y-O-U-N-I-Q-U-E. She just did this the other day. All right, what I'm gonna add to my hair, I was gonna use this Carol's Daughter, no, this Kinky Curly Gloss Pomade, just a bunch of oils, but it's got little beady beads in my hand and I'd be straight stupid to just go ahead and put that on my hair. So let me find some other type of oil product. All right, so this part is really easy. You just see me twisting. I'm doing them tight to the root, or as tight as I can do it. Putting my end papers on the end and then rolling it up with the black perm rod and keeping it moving. So I've actually ended up with 5 rows starting from the top and just kind of parting going around my head horizontally. And now you're gonna see a picture of once the rollers are all in. And all the goop on my neck. So warning, there's some utter ridiculousness about to take place in this video. You have been warned. Proceed with caution. Hey y'all, so I don't know how this is gonna come out, because what had happened was I tried to sit under the dryer, but I have a problem sitting under the dryer, even at the hair salon. Like, I be sneaking my head out, you know, while she ain't looking, and I put my head back in, and they be like, "Why it's not dry?" I'm like, "I don't know why it ain't dry anyway." So with my little hood thing, I kind of took it off and then put it back on. And I figured through all these take it off and put it back on, throughout the day it ought to be dry, and it wasn't. And last night, there was no way I was about to sleep with these hard ass rollers in my head. These things hard, okay? So what I did was I just slipped them out and then pin curled them. So it does seem dry. Hell, I hope it's dry. So look, mistake number one. You see how that's all wonky? Like, that's not... Okay. Mistake number one was I shouldn't have used the Curly Magic for a set, just because it's got a lot of glycerin in it, and glycerin takes forever to dry. Mistake number two... Well, no, I'll make that one mistake number two. Mistake number one was using these big rods. Even though my hair is long and I rolled it around the rod a while, I wanted these tighter. And that didn't happen. So I should have used smaller rods. But see, I was going to use smaller rods at first, but I've had my smaller rods for so dang long that I think the rubber is kind of dry. I don't know, but they keep coming apart. You know what I mean? They keep popping off. So I need some more smaller rods. So let me go ahead and take this out and see what we got. I feel like that's damp, but shh. I ain't sitting on the dryer no more. Yeah. So I pin curled them. And Let's see. Yeah, it looked like a drunk twist out. That's what this looks like. Like, I went through all that with the dryer and whatnot, and I could have just did a twist out and left well enough alone, but lesson learned. I should have used the product that had a little firmer hold to it, because the curly magic is good for a wash and go, but I thought because it was kind of like jelly like a gel like that, it would have had a little firmer hold, but it didn't. Like, and then I should have used a smaller rod, right, so I could get a shorter look, right, because I want it kind of tight, right? So I think, you know, I'll be fine, right, for a little while, right, but I'm gonna have to do something different. This look means I'm looking for another twist that may be in here. That's what that goofy look means. Okay. All done. Okay. Like I said, it'll do. It's not exactly what I was expecting. I mean, it's got good stretch to it, you know. Feeling silly. I ain't even had my coffee yet. It's got a good stretch to it, you know, so for that reason, like, it was good that I used the big rods, you know, but, like, my original idea was to have a shorter rod, right? So, like, I wanted it shorter, you know, and so, and then it's raining, and so I was expecting if it was shorter, you know, and tighter curl that it would fall, and see, it's already fallen, so it's gonna really just fall on out, you know? I don't know, I need to get off the damn camera right now.